It's time to get back to nature. Do you enjoy suffering and the cold and the North Pole? Today we embark upon a humbling spiritual journey into the Arctic. All that really matters is a desire to learn. Here we begin our quest. There is practically nothing, a single snow hare and a single polar bear. The rest is just nothing as far as the eye can see. And there's only one way to play this scenario. Build a fire in the center. Don't second guess too much. We'll lay down some sleeping spots. A single torch, a door, and make everywhere else a stockpile. My colonists will know the meaning of suffering if they are to survive. Among our five tribal colonists, we have two cannibals, Orange and Seika are cannibals. They're the only ones who will be able to survive in this land. Everyone else who's a non-cannibal will probably. Since we have a yak, we might save this. It might help us to survive. But Grigory is gonna have to go. I am working off of a guide for this entire playthrough, as it's practically impossible to do this. So building two more stools and a table, and doubling over some crafting spots, last but not least a campfire, and a simple research bench. This layout should pretty much maximize the use of everything we've got here. For now. The next step will be to arrest most of my colonists. So I'm going to have them all arrest each other. There's not too many ways to play this whole thing. We've got to arrest anyone who's not a cannibal. And what better place to begin? Great. We're also going to not allow them to refuel the fire, and send out Orange to go hunt the snow hare. Kangaroo will go ahead and arrest our other colonists, and then we're going to sell them on the black market. Last but not least, Kangaroo's done all of our dirty work, but we're going to arrest him as well. So right after Orange hauls in the snow hare, we'll go arrest him too. We'll just have him drop his pemmican, and then we'll have them both arrest him. And it says that Orange has a better chance of arresting him, so I'm gonna have Orange arrest Kangaroo. If he resists, great, he didn't resist. So now we have three colonists under arrest, and we're going to need silver. We'll form a caravan and send it out to this neighboring tribe. So taking all three prisoners, who are in pretty good condition, and also our dogs, too, we send them on their journey with Seika. Unfortunately, they'll become very hungry, but we'll just have to buy food when we get there. And so the quest begins. Now, while Seika and the prisoners leave our colony, let's chat a moment what makes this scenario interesting. As stated on the wiki guide, the sea ice biome is the coldest one in the game. There's almost no animal life and no plants. There's no building materials, there's nothing. And the tribal start is devoid of technology. What makes Rimworld a pain is that there are always people raiding you. But what if you could make those people raiding you into a resource for food? Thus, sea ice is the purest way to play Rimworld, and I assert is the way that the game is meant to be played. Now we'll just watch them all wander off the edge of the map, and here they gather, and thither they go. Our first agenda with our merchandise colonists will be to sell them for anything. We've hunted the only animals on the map, and there's really nothing left. There is one polar bear, but this will be a slight hassle to how it survive. Obviously, one of the main limitations is going to be the cold. It's going to get extremely cold. It will never be the right season for growing. I don't know if you've noticed, but there's also literally no resources on the map. We only get whatever wanders in, which means that raids are actually a good thing for us. We want to be raided to get materials from the raiders. And the tribal start means we can't do anything. We can't even make a bed yet. What little we can do is to assign Orange to construction and tell Orange to bring the rabbit back outside. Most of our food will be mead, and we need it to stay outside so that it doesn't spoil. This will just slightly prolong the shelf life of our food to keep it out here. After one day, our caravans made it about a third of the way to the base we're trying to trade with. They'll have barely enough food to get there, but we'll need more to get back. Orange is in pretty good spirits, but it won't be long before he starts to touch his mental break threshold, so I'm going to have him build a hoopstone ring when he wakes up. Nutmeg is a male yak, so I don't think we'll be able to get any milk from him. He's probably just gonna be prolonged as meat if we keep him alive, though. The temperature outside has become freezing now, and the snow hare actually won't spoil. It will still deteriorate because it's outdoors, we just need shelves. Now, at the beginning of day two, I'm going to have him butcher the hare. And we've doubled over the stool both for dining and butchering, so it'll at least improve the quality of his comfort throughout the day. Now, Orange has butchered the snow hare. We got some leather out of it, too. Instead of using the pemmican, we'll also have him make one meal. Orange isn't a good cook at all, so there's a decent chance he'll get food poisoning. We'll just have to cross our fingers here. Orange is eating the meal, and so far, no food poisoning. Now, I'll construct the hoopstone ring with the wood that he has in the cabin, he's fairly good at constructing, and it'll get better. So for right now, he's made it this far. We'll let him relax socially a little bit longer just to maximize his mood, and then after that, I'm going to equip him with the Pila. It seems to have slightly better stats than the bow, and I want to take out this polar bear. So equipping the Pila in place of the bow, and with the outdoor temperatures at 42 degrees Fahrenheit, so he probably won't get too cold from here, we'll send up Orange to hunt the polar bear. He also has a range of 23 with the Pila, so I think that this should be enough to keep the polar bear from getting angry at us. The farther away we are from the polar bear, the less likely it is to attack. We don't really need to kill it, we just need to wound it and cause it to bleed. And we'll just wait till it gets into his range. We can walk one more over and then shoot it. One more up. We really want to keep the max range from this thing, but it takes a while to aim the Pila. There goes one. Right in. Stabbed in the right eye with a Pila, but no immediate danger. That's a very good hit for us, because it means if the polar bear does fight us, we'll probably be safe from the polar bear for a while. Let's try again. The blood is just gushing everywhere. Pila number two at the polar bear. Now it's getting closer, but we won't really change it. We have angered the polar bear. We've stabbed it in the right kidney, and now it's angry. It's time to run. Hopefully it's moving more slowly. It's going to die in 20 hours, but it seems to match Orange in speed more or less. I also can't imagine that it's doing particularly well because it's been hit in the right eye. At this point, we could have Orange just retreat inside. You know, on second thought, I think we're just going to debuild the wall and then run away. This might lead to a really nice loop here where the polar bear just goes back and forth. Excellent. Now the polar bear is... We've effectively played monkey in the middle with a maddened polar bear. We'll probably get one more shot with a Pila added, and this one might be fatal. And there we go. One more. And we hit it in the right leg, so that should lower its movement and manipulation. Only at 78% of moving now. Great, we should be able to finish this thing off now. It is very close behind us, too. Let's just have Orange run away. Great. Now we're outrunning the polar bear, and that is how you hunt a polar bear. Now it's experiencing blood loss, and it's moving even more slowly. Great job to Orange. We're going to need to turn eventually, because the polar bear does eventually reach the map edge. We'll just have a trail of polar bear blood going around the map. Great, we'll get one more Pila in and hopefully finish it off even faster. This one was to its skull. It cracked its skull, and Orange has enough time to get away. Fortunately, there's no such thing as fight or flight in RimWorld, it just dies. Run away, Orange. Obviously, this will involve some cleanup later, but there's not much else to do out here in the sea ice biome. Take one more shot. And this one is also a hit. This one was just in its body, further lowering the movement speed to 52%, and now I think Orange is quite safe. One more shot. And that's the kill. Great work, Orange. Now we have a polar bear we can bring back to base. Obviously, this involved quite a long blood trail, but I'd say overall, this was a worthwhile kill. There will probably be a lot more blood all over the map by the time we're done. And our caravan has finally arrived at Lega. Now we can do the trading. We'll trade our three colonists. We're really supposed to get about $1,500 for these, but we did even better. I'd say this is worth over $2,200. We'll also sell them our Husky and our Yorkshire Terrier. We just can't really use them. And they do have a lot of steel. We need lots and lots of steel to make this work. They have hens, but unfortunately no muffalo, which we would need to carry more goods. The yak might have made for a good pack animal, but I'd really like to make sure that we have more food. We'll keep the yak around and see if we can keep him alive. Unfortunately, that's about all that we can carry with us right now. For right now, it might be better for us to keep one person with us. Kangaroo will help us carry back our goods, and we might have to eat kangaroo when we get back. This way, we'll be able to bring back 523 rice, a good amount of steel, and more wood. That'll do for now. We accept. And now we've traded, so we've improved relations with this tribe. Kangaroo gets to live a little bit longer, and Orange has a good meal back at home. This polar bear should be able to feed us for a little while as well. That gives us 33 bear skin and 7 light leather, as well as a good haul of 89 meat. We also managed to keep the front door intact, and that gives Orange more of a chance to repair, further improving his construction skills. Orange is going to get more cooking skill, but we really can't feed Nutmeg, so we're going to need to kill Nutmeg too. It's unfortunate, but we just don't have the food to spare. At least the leather will be worthwhile, and Orange gets to eat a decent meal. We just need to clean off all of this blood. While alone, Orange gets more skill at cooking. These might lead to food poisoning, but, well, there's not much else to do out here. And the next best thing we can have him do is butcher meat. That at least gives him skill while it doesn't risk food poisoning. And now we have tons and tons of meat. Now we have some visitors from the Covenant of the Ifthwalia. We'll see if they have anything worthwhile. They have two guns on them. And since they're our only trading partner, we really want to be careful with these people and make sure that they're happy. We'll see what they have to trade and work from there. So they're willing to buy our short bows. They have components, which I would like, but I actually won't have enough money for anything else, so. And we'll send Orange off to clean the rest of the blood. Most days pass by in uneventfulness. That's how it is in the Arctic, and we'll wait for the caravan to arrive back home. The caravan's arrived back, and we have everything again. Kangaroo was slow and stressed, probably not long for this world, and he was also bonded to the animal we gave away. Saika, however, is doing fine. Saika is primarily there to be our researcher, and we'll welcome her back into the house with all of her rice and medicine, her components, and her bed, and then we'll install that inside so that she can sleep in it. Now this will be Saika's, and Kangaroo is actually stuck outside. We're just going to unload him, and then we might eat him. That might be what we do next. Unfortunately, Kangaroo has decided to throw a tantrum. It's now time to just murder him. He won't be long for this world, so it's best that we just, you know, take him away. We'll take him out of here. He isn't really much use to us anyway. Now, we could have geared them up better, but I just didn't want him to take any of the meat. And as long as it's only bruises and punches, they'll be okay. It looks like Kangaroo's not long for this world, and no one was bit or got anything in risk of an infection, so we're quite fine, actually. We'll just beat him to death now. Just avert your eyes. We just need that, and now... Okay, that's another meal. Good stuff. And Orange will actually get a witness death with bloodlust, so he's going to get buffed for the next couple days. They'll need to rest for a little while, but this is net overall a good thing. They'll enjoy a meal. Unfortunately, not a cannibal meal yet, but we'll get to that. Now, we're going to allow Saika to finish off the research bench. Although she doesn't have as much passion for construction, we can't really mess this one up. So we need to be careful here. We could build two of these things to speed our progress as well. And we have plenty of light here too. Now the first thing we'll research will be complex clothing. We're going to need it if we want to make anything to keep us warm in the Arctic. We'll start making use of all of this bear leather. And we have a psychic soothe on males. That's really lucky. Orange didn't really need it, but it'll make him even better off. Unfortunately, Saika and Orange have got off under the wrong start, and they're rivals. So they're just going to be sort of tolerating each other at the beginning here. Fortunately, a little bit of chatter and tending to wounds should hopefully make them a little bit closer. Now they're acquaintances. Although Orange isn't a very good doctor, he is friendly. And we can let Saika get some experience tending to Orange as well. This way, in case if anything really bad happens, they do have some chance at survival. And sure enough, this tending brings up their experience. And they've gotten into a social fight. Yeah, really not great. They're biting each other. Bite on the leg, And Saika has won the fight and is now eating a meal. Orange is going to die in 7 hours, but we're going need to rescue him. We also have visitors, apparently. I'm a little worried about these bites because, well, those could get infected, but more doctoring experience. At the very least, we'll have her use medicine to heal him. Let's find out what these traders have to offer. Not much we can do here, but we can at least buy more pemmican. We'll accept. It's food. It'll feed us for longer. Now we're being raided by the Cervexa Covenant. Fortunately, it's only one guy with a club, and we do have visitors, so we should be fine, because both of my colonists are incapacitated from fighting each other. We'll still try to have them make friends, despite the fact that they're rivals again. And these visitors should defend me from the enemy. Yeah, they're just fighting them. Great, so we had visitors for the first, battle. And if this guy goes down, I'm definitely gonna strip his hat. Yep, here we go. We're gonna strip him. That's more meals and cold weather clothing. Great, we'll take all of that. And that's a hat for us. Victory. Saika's now gone on an insulting spree, but I think that Orange can take it already. She's bit him, and, well, in order to combat all of this, I think I'm just going to have Orange eat. Another person. That's probably gonna be the only thing that brings him back from all of this. It's time for some cannibalism. And we have more visitors again. All these visitors. Wonderful. Great stuff. Orange is not in a good mood. He's been bit, he's been insulted. I'm going to have him eat some human meat. Just all of the absurd things are keeping him together. And we'll just do our best here to cook the last of this meat. And we got a gift, a marble club. And now Saika is finally up and at him, researching, and production is underway. I do love the sound of it. We'll be at Complex Clothing in no time. Although we don't have enough human leather yet, we can use this plain leather to make another bedroll too, and then replace Orange's sleeping spot with that. That Galga passed away, and it's time to take away her corpse. This will be more human leather, hopefully for some clothing for Orange. It would make him really glad. With his bloodlust. It'll also improve his cooking. And there we go, 35 leather now. Most days, Orange just rests while Psyker researches now. Things they talk about are blades, sweet foods, swimming, dice, short people, and backgammon. In order to keep Orange and Psyker away from each other and prevent social fights, I'm sending Orange on a caravan. When he gets back, hopefully the research will be completed and Psyker will be done. Otherwise, they just hate each other. It's pretty much worst-case social scenario. Just finished Complex Clothing. Next, we're going to need Complex Furniture. In time, it will help us. Though the hand tailor bench will require 75 wood. We'll need to trade for this, obviously. Finally, our caravan has arrived. And we can offload everything we have and just buy wood. And we just have to accept this trade. But now, back at home, someone has fallen out of the sky. Biko. He's also a rival of, Saika. She doesn't like anyone, so probably just going to take off his clothes and then eat him too. We will take them off, but for now it's just another meal. He wasn't very good. Goodbye. And some cougars are now migrating through. One has gone mad. We'll need to negotiate this carefully. We can allow the mountain lion to eat Biko lying on the ground, and I think we'll just take a moment to observe its behavior. And sure enough, there it goes for Biko. And it looks like it'll kite back and forth. It prefers Saika because she's live, but if we close the door again, then it goes back to Biko. I was just standing there confused, still maddened, but now just wandering around. Oh, we can just let Saika eat inside. There's a good chance this cougar will just wander off. And sure enough, the cougar has calmed down. Who knows what got a hold of it. Now Biko will probably pass from this earth, and Saika should be just fine. Orange's caravan has run out of food, but he should make it back in time before he goes mad. And we're being raided. It's only one warrior with a club, but he does have on a duster, and we want to take him alive if possible. Still, we have a superior weapon, and Saika has the brawler trait, which means she has a better chance of faring okay in melee combat. It'll be a while before Orange gets back, so it looks like Saika's on her own. And the assault begins. The raider comes around, and we'll see what he does first. Looks like he's going for the walls. He's going to set fire to him, but we can greet him outside and begin our fight. It looks like Saika scored a good first hit, and that's it for him. Pretty lucky, but the brawler trait is kind of overpowered in melee combat. We'll quickly take off all of his items and strip him and then capture him, or rather leave him there for now, though we can wear the duster. He's trying to escape. We're going to just leaving another trail of blood, and that's enough. And since it looks like this is going to be a nail biter, we're going to have Saika meet him out there with some food. Saika will just gather the materials, and off she goes. She'll meet him out there, and then they can get back together. This one's a real nail biter now. As long as Saika holds it together, we'll be fine. And we had some alpacas join, too. They'll be there for when we get back. And we can merge the caravans, and they should travel back slowly, but they will survive. And just like that, Orange is back up, having eaten some rice, and there'll be plenty of food for when we return. Of course, immediately upon return, they get into a social fight, and Saika's right big toe has been destroyed. They really can't tolerate one another. Well, I hate to do this, but I just think that Saika is the weakest link here. They both hate each other. Really the worst possible thing, I'm just going to have her stand out there in the water. We're really better off without this colonist. And if we can, we want to keep her physical body. It's more food. And great, she's got a medical emergency from hypothermia. This'll make him much happier. And now he can work on cheerfully alone. Saika has died, and that's enough of that. Now, Orange will go on and eat Saika. Now he can take the duster, and there's plenty of food. We're still suffering from hypothermia, though, and we're gonna need to address this now. The first thing we can do is to set up a tailoring bench. He's botched the first construction, wasting some wood. And next he can create a parka from human leather. This will help his mood, and it will also keep him much warmer than he would be. He's also glad that Saika is dead. Now Orange is just about finished with his parka, and what was our quality? We got awful quality, but we didn't really expect quality. It will at least keep him warm, and it'll make him very happy. There, he gets a 2 mood buff from it. And this is about double as much insulation as he had with the duster. Some huskies have joined our colony. Weirdly, just more food for us. But since we're relying on events to keep ourselves alive, it's a welcome change of pace. Orange is just about recovered from the bites with no infections, and now he's back to work. And then he'll finish off research on complex furniture. Now he learns with a double passion, so he's faster than Saika at improving. This is fortunate because he's starting off at a much lower level. We're now down to 1 colonist. Although that is alarming, he is a very good colonist. We've got a transport pod crash with someone named Marina. She might join us, and she's from our faction, it says. But she's not a cannibal, so she probably won't fit in here. That's another meal on the horizon. And she has a synth red parka of normal quality. Light leather pants as well, and a mega sloth wool button-down shirt. We'll take all of that, it's great stuff. So sure enough, we'll send off Orange to get her items, and we'll just wear everything right here on the spot. Then we'll haul the rest of this back and leave her out there. It may not be the nicest thing, but you do what you have to for survival. We'll also need to slaughter one of these alpaca now. And there we go, another. And Husky 2 has his eyes on it, so we'll just slaughter Husky 2. Now we can begin the butchering, but you do what you have to. Now we've finished on complex furniture and we can move on to electricity. This will really improve our lives. And it looks like things are going to be getting very interesting for Orange. Inside the house, it's now frozen. Though he's doing okay temperature-wise from his clothing. It's a life. I think we'll leave it there for now. Lots of wandering ahead. We'll need more caravans and more events if we want to survive in this hostile environment. But I think that that's enough for one day. We've got started and we've already got 2 technologies researched. I think Orange is ready to hunker down and survive now. As always, God bless my patrons. Thank you for your support. I hope you enjoyed the video. And as always, I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye.